on the town line on Flora Street, by the Londonderry town line.
It was the early morning hours of April 13th. Fire crews were called to this Londonderry home.
A location on a high hydrant. I'm showing it's approximately three house lots away, probably, I don't know, I'm just guessing probably 600 to 800 feet.
Inside, a mother and daughter were killed. Outside, fire crews had one big challenge. There was no nearby water supply.
Yeah, it's about 800 to 900 feet from the nearest hydrant. The nearest hydrant is actually in Derry.
Fast forward 1 week later, flames destroyed this rural home in Madbury. Again, the nearest hydrant was in a neighboring community.
Being a rural community, water supply was our biggest thing to overcome.
The state fire marshal says this is a growing problem as more neighborhoods are built further away from water systems. Rural fire departments often have to truck their water into scenes. Since extending hydrants isn't feasible, many towns have adopted two, sometimes controversial, requirements to get water: residential sprinklers or what's called a cistern.
So what we have here, this is a typical cistern installation for the town of New Boston.
In the 1980s, New Boston started requiring that builders install this man-made water supply near new subdivisions.
We should be able to spin it.
Originally designed by New Boston's John Bunting, it's basically
it
a huge underground water tank where fire trucks can hook into. They can cost $50,000 or more. And fire officials say while these help, it still can take more than 10 minutes to get to the scene just to use it.
In the residential areas, we have what they call a hidden head.
So in 2002, New Boston went a step further, requiring some new subdivision homes to have residential sprinklers.
Each house has a 300-gallon tank.
Complete with their own water supplies in the basement. So if a fire breaks out, as you can see in this promotional video, it could be put out almost instantly. Officials see this as the future.
What it does is it provides you the life safety to evacuate in time.
Now, several communities have adopted rules requiring developers put in either a cistern or residential sprinklers in new subdivisions. But officials we spoke with say sprinklers are the preferred and encouraged option. In at least one case in Lebanon, the chief says the required sprinklers saved a man's life. The Hollis fire chief says this 2008 fatal fire happened in a neighborhood that had a water cistern. He believes the man's life could have been saved if sprinklers were in the home. The state fire marshal would like to see more towns adopt sprinkler requirements, but there are some who say this goes too far.
And frankly, these are very expensive systems, and you don't see them being put in voluntarily. It's usually because it is required. We are seeing more of that.
Paul Morin of the New Hampshire Builders Association says while sprinklers are a good idea, many consumers don't want the added cost and maintenance. The state fire marshal believes systems would add about $3,000 to $4,000 on average to a home price. Morin says it can add anywhere from $5,000 or more.
We have no problem putting in the system. For us, it's just plumbing. We're builders. When you have a buyer, though, that thinks that it's too expensive or maybe it prices them right out of the market, that's a problem for us.
Morin would like residential sprinklers to be voluntary. In fact, there is now legislation in Concord that would prevent any more sprinkler requirements from being adopted by local towns. But fire officials argue it's a small cost to pay for saving a life. Even comparing residential sprinklers to the car industry's early reluctance to add seatbelts.
Well, I guess I'd refer back to cars when they didn't have seatbelts and they didn't have the airbags. They all added cost to the cars, but they also add a lot of safety.
We should point out these requirements target newly built homes, not existing homes. As for accidents with these water systems, the New Boston chief says they only had one pipe burst that was not properly installed. Otherwise, their 160 home systems have not malfunctioned. I'm Sean McDonald, WMUR News 9.